So in this session, we will be discussing about the matrix chain multiplication. Topic is matrix chain multiplication. And this matrix chain multiplication is also a part of dynamic programming. We have seen dynamic programming, and this matrix chain multiplication is also a part of dynamic programming. Okay. So before we even study this matrix chain multiplication, we should know how can we, implement this multiplication in two matrices, how the multiplication is done between two matrices. So we should know the basics of that. So once you know the basics of multiplication, how multiplication is done, then we can try and understand how can we minimize the number of multiplications in that case. Okay. So let us see this matrix chain multiplication here. So before we start, we should know how matrix multiplication is done. So let us assume that this is the first matrix that we have, and here in the first matrix, this is called as a matrix A. This will be your matrix A, and in this matrix A, we are having the elements which is A11, A12, A21, A22, A31, and A32. So basically, in this matrix is a 3 cross 2 matrix, because there are 3 rows and there are 2 columns. It is a 3 cross 2 matrix. In the same way, I might be having one more matrix here. So this is a matrix B, and in this matrix B, we have B11, B12, B31, B21, B22, and B23. So this is a 2 cross 3 matrix. Now, in these matrix, this first number here, it represents the number of rows, and this second number represents the number of columns. Okay, so if you multiply between these two matrices, how can this multiplication happen? What will be the result of this multiplication? Let us see that result. So after multiplying, you will get this something like this. That is, when we multiply, it is row into column. Okay. So that means I'm going to multiply A11 with B11 plus A12 with B21. Correct? In the same way, again, row into column. So again, A11 with B12 plus A12 with B22. Okay, and again, for the third also, it is A11 with B13 plus 812 with B23. Okay, so this will be your first row. In the same way, we have to do it for the second row also. So in the second row, again, we are going to do the same. So it is A21 multiplied by B11 plus A22 multiplied by B21. And again, A21 multiplied by B12 plus A22 multiplied by B22. Again, A21 multiplied by B13 plus A22 multiplied by B23. In the same way, for the third row also, so A31 multiplied by B11 plus A32 multiplied by B21. And here again, A31 multiplied by B12 plus A32 multiplied by B22. Sorry. And again, here A31 multiplied by B13 plus A32 multiplied by B23. Okay, so this is the result of this multiplication. And let us assume that this result will be represented in this manner. So this is representing your matrix number C. So here, these elements I'm representing this manner. So it is C11, C12, C13, C21, C22, C23, and C31, C32, and C33. Okay. Now, in this case, you can see that this entire equation will be having some result, and this entire equation I am representing by C11. Is puri equation ko main C11 se represent kar raha hun. Okay. Now, in this case, first of all, two things should be clear, that when you do multiplication in matrix, how you do the multiplication. Ye aapko clear hona chahiye. First of all, you should know how to do the multiplication. the multiplication. I hope that all of you are comfortable with how to do the multiplication of two matrix. This is the first thing that you should know. And secondly, when you are doing the multiplication, then what will be the dimensions of resultant matrix? So what will be the dimensions of resulting matrix? जो आपके पास रिजल्टिंग मैट्रिक्स आएगा उसकी डायमेंशंस क्या होगी, वट विल बी द डायमेंशंस ऑफ रिजल्टिंग मैट्रिक्स. सो फॉर एग्जांपल हियर यू कैन सी द डायमेंशंस ऑफ दिस रिजल्टिंग मैट्रिक्स इज 3x3. एंड थर्ड वी शुड नो वट आर द नंबर ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशंस रिक्वायर्ड, और वट आर द नंबर ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशंस डन. तो यहाँ पर कितनी मल्टीप्लीकेशंस होंगी, वट इज द नंबर ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशंस डन. ओके, so right, so and again one more thing is required, if two matrix are compatible with each other also. So I can say whether the two matrices are compatible with each other. Are compatible for multiplication or not, compatible for multiplication or not. So these four things you should know, कि जो मैट्रिक्स के अंदर हम मल्टीप्लीकेशन कर रहे हैं आर दोज टू मैट्रिक्स कंपैटिबल और नॉट. सेकेंडली हाउ टू डू द मल्टीप्लीकेशन. थर्ड वट विल बी द डायमेंशन ऑफ द रिजल्टेंट मैट्रिक्स. एंड द फोर्थ वन इज वट इज द नंबर ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशंस दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड. ओके, सो लेट अस अज्यूम दिस इज द फर्स्ट मैट्रिक्स विच इज हैविंग द डायमेंशन एज पी इंटू क्यू, एंड दिस इज द सेकेंड मैट्रिक्स विच इज हैविंग द डायमेंशन एज क्यू इंटू आर. So when can you do the multiplications? If you want to do the multiplication between these two matrices, in that case this Q and this Q should be the same. What do I mean to say by this is that the number of columns in the first matrix should be equal to the number of rows in the second matrix. Only if the number of columns in the first matrix is equal to the number of rows in the second matrix, only in that case we will be able to do the multiplication, otherwise we will not be able to do the multiplication. Jaise ki yahan par if you can clearly see, this 2 is actually equivalent to this 2. So that is the number of columns in the first matrix is actually equivalent to the number of columns in the second matrix. First of all, this should be clear. Now, whatever the resultant matrix will be, जो भी आपकी resultant matrix यहाँ पर आएगी, whatever the resultant matrix will be, that will be having a dimension of P cross R. उसके dimension होंगी P cross R. So what is P? This is the P. ये P है, this is the P that we are using. And this is the R that we are having. So the dimensions of the resultant matrix will be P cross R. For example, here, this is the value of P and this is the value of R. So 3 cross 3, so this resultant matrix is having a dimension of 3 cross 3. This should be clear. Okay. Now, the next important question is, what is the number of multiplications that are required? Kitni multiplications ki requirement hai? How many multiplications are required? Just look at it here. You will see that this is the first multiplication. This is the second multiplication, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17. So basically here, not really 17, this should be total 6 into 3, 18. So total of 18 multiplications are required. I think this is something that I missed. So total here, 18 multiplications are required. यहाँ पर 18 multiplications की requirement है. And what is the number of additions here? So number of additions are basically total of 9 additions. So I need 18 multiplications and I need 9 additions to perform this multiplication. So if in general case, if I want to ask you that the dimension of first matrix is P cross Q, the dimension of the second matrix is Q cross R, and the resultant matrix is P cross R, then what is the total number of multiplications that are required? Kitni multiplications ki requirement hogi? So can you answer this question? How many multiplications are required in this case? How many multiplications are required? You will understand that in this particular case, the number of multiplications that are required, number of multiplications that are required is basically equivalent to P cross Q cross R. This is the total of number of multiplications that are required. Okay, so you can clearly see if in the third matrix this is the value of P, this is the value of Q, this is the value of Q, and this is the value of R. Therefore, it is P cross Q cross R will be equal to 3 cross 2 cross 3, that is equal to 18. So you can clearly see that here 18 multiplications are required. Total aapke paas 18 multiplications ki requirement hai. So to perform this, right? So these are the things that you should know. So I've answered 4 questions here. First of all, whether a matrix is compatible or not. When can we say the matrix is compatible? If the number of columns in the first matrix is equal to the number of rows in the second matrix, then we can say the matrix multiplications, those two matrices are compatible for multiplication. Secondly, how can we do the multiplication? I've shown you how can we do the multiplication, that is multiply the rows into the columns. And third, what will be the dimensions of resulting matrix? I told you the dimensions of resulting matrix will be P cross R. And the fourth one, what will be the number of multiplications that are required? That is equal to P cross Q cross R. So these many multiplications are required. Okay, so those basic questions are clear. Now, if those basic questions are clear, then why are we really interested in matrixial multiplication? हम matrix chain multiplication में इतना interested क्यों है? Why are we even showing it so much interest in matrix chain multiplication? So this should be clear. Okay? So why to study this matrix chain multiplication? Why to study matrix chain multiplication? Now, why to study the matrix chain multiplication? Let me show you with the help of an example. Okay, let us assume that we have 3 matrix. This is the matrix number A, this is the matrix number B, and this is the matrix number C. And the dimensions of matrix A is 2 cross 1. Let us take some random example. The dimensions of matrix number B is 1 cross 2, and the dimensions of matrix number C is 2 cross 3. These are the dimensions. Okay. So if you want to do multiplication of these matrices, now in how many ways you can multiply them? Kitne tarike se aap inko multiply kar sakte hain? So in how many ways you can multiply these matrices? In how many ways you can do it? So the first way is either you multiply A cross B first, and whatever the result is, you are going to multiply with C. Or what you can do is, you can multiply A with B cross C. So basically I have two ways, in those two ways I can multiply this A cross B cross C. So dono multiply karne ke liye hamare paas do tarike hain. Okay, so again, this matrix A is 2 cross 1, this matrix B is 1 cross 2, this matrix C is 2 cross 3. Again, this matrix A is 2 cross 1, matrix B is 1 cross 2, and matrix C is 2 cross 3. If you do it in this manner, then the resultant of A cross B here, the resultant of A cross B will be having a dimensions. So the resultant of this will be having dimensions of 2 cross 2. And the number of multiplications will be, and number of multiplications that will be done is 2 cross 1 cross 2, that is equal to total 4 multiplications are required. Okay. And then whatever the result is, for example, here the resultant dimension matrix here will be, let us suppose it is D. And this D matrix will be having a dimension of 2 cross 2. And you are going to multiply with matrix C, which is having a dimension of 3. Therefore, the resultant matrix here, maybe that resultant matrix is E, and that will be having a dimensions of 2 cross 3. Okay. So now, because E is having a dimensions of 2 cross 3, so here in this case, what is the number of multiplications are required? Number of multiplications required is 2 cross 2 cross 3. That is equal to total 12 multiplications. So yahan par aapko 12 multiplications chahiye. So what is the total number of multiplication? Yahan par total kitna hoga? What is the total number of multiplications? That is 4 plus 12 is equal to 16 multiplications in total. Aapko yahan par total 16 multiplications ki requirement hogi. But if you go with the second case, if you go with this second case here, now in this second case, if you multiply B with C, then the resultant matrix, let us assume that resultant matrix is D. So the dimensions of this resultant matrix will be 1 cross 3. And to multiply B with C, the number of multiplications that are required is 1 cross 2 cross 3, which is equal to 6. So it will be requiring total of 6 multiplications. Okay, fine. Now this A, that is 2 cross 1, will be multiplied by D 1 cross 3. So here in this case, the resultant matrix will be E, and this E matrix will be having a dimensions of 2 cross 3. So you can clearly see the dimension of this matrix will be equal to the dimension of this matrix. So even if you multiply them in any order, the resultant will be the same. But what will be the number of multiplications required for this? The number of multiplications that will be required is 2 cross 1 cross 3, that is equal to total 6. So in total, how many multiplications required in this scenario? Is second scenario mein how many multiplications are required? So number of multiplications in total is equal to 6 plus 6, which is equal to 12. So you need only 12 multiplications here in the second case. In the first case, we needed 16 multiplications. In the second case, we needed 12 multiplications. So we can clearly see that there's a difference about what is the number of multiplications required. And how this difference is created? This difference is created because the way we are multiplying the matrix. Because it can happen that you can associate these brackets here first, and here we are associating these brackets. So the way we are multiplying the matrix, even though the dimensions are same, even though the result is same, but what the number of multiplications that are required is changing in both of these two cases. Clear so far? Itna sabhi ke saath clear hai? Now, one of my very important question that we actually need here to understand is that is matrix multiplication commutative? Kya hamara jo matrix multiplication hai wo commutative hai? Is matrix multiplication commutative? Commutative. Kya matrix multiplication commutative hai? So we will see this matrix multiplication is not commutative. मैट्रिक्स मल्टीप्लीकेशन जो है वो कॉम्यूटेटिव नहीं है. व्हाट डू आई मीन टू से बाय दिस इज दैट इफ वी हैव फर्स्ट मैट्रिक्स, मे बी वी हैव अ मैट्रिक्स ए विद द डायमेंशंस 2 क्रॉस 3 एंड वी हैव अ मैट्रिक्स बी विद द डायमेंशंस 3 क्रॉस 4. सो द रिजल्टेंट मैट्रिक्स विल बी मैट्रिक्स सी एंड द डायमेंशंस ऑफ दिस मैट्रिक्स सी विल बी 2 क्रॉस 4. ओके, सो दैट मीन्स आई हैव मल्टीप्लाइड विद ए विद बी. Okay, so I can do A multiplied by B, but in this case I will not be able to do B multiplied by A. Yahan par B multiplied by A cannot be done. Okay, so it cannot be done. Why? These two are not compatible. Okay, so even if they are not compatible, let us assume in general case, if we say that they are A multiplied by B is also compatible, B multiplied by A is also compatible. Let us assume that we have this scenario that we have a matrix A which is having the dimensions 2 cross 3 and we have a matrix B which is having the dimensions 3 cross 2. Therefore, multiplying A multiplied by B is also, you know, this is also compatible, as well as even if you do B multiplied by A, that is also, you know, compatible. So both of these two multiplications are compatible here. Fine, but the problem here is if you get the result of this matrix, then the resultant matrix C here will be having a dimensions of 2 cross 2. But in this case, in the second case, the resultant matrix C will be having a dimensions of 3 cross 3. So when I say is matrix multiplication commutative or not, that means I want to say if A cross B is equal to B cross A or not. Kya A cross B, B cross A ke equal hai ya fir nahi hai? So the answer here is in most of the cases they are not commutative. So if only in a few case they will be same, because when we have a matrix with both the dimensions are same. Okay, so let us assume that we have this matrix 1 1 1 1 1 1 and the dimensions are 3 cross 3. If you multiply it by 1 1 1 1 1 1 with the dimensions are 3 cross 3, so in this case this matrix will be commutative. But the problem is we do not really look for only one solution, we have to give a generalization. So in case of a generalization, you will see that matrix multiplication is not commutative. Aapki jo matrix multiplication hai wo commutative nahi hai. This should be clear with everyone. So that means A cross B is not equal to B cross A. Okay, so here in this case, when we have done this, if we have done this, that means it is not equal to, so that means this is not equal to saying that we have A multiplied by C multiplied by B. They are not same. Ye same nahi hai. Because as I said, matrix multiplication is not commutative. Therefore, you cannot do it in this manner. So whenever you have to multiply the matrices, the order in which you are multiplying, that should be maintained. Wo jo order hai, wo maintain hona chahiye. You cannot change the position of the matrices. Aap matrices ki position ko change nahi kar sakte. Okay? Now, the third question is, in how many ways you can multiply the matrix? Aap matrices ko kitne ways mein multiply kar sakte hai? Okay? So let me answer this. In how many ways can we multiply the matrix? In how many ways can we multiply the matrix? आप कितने ways के अंदर matrices को multiply कर सकते हैं? Okay? So if we have three, if we have only two matrix, so like for example, if we have matrix A and if we have matrix B, and let us assume both of these matrices are compatible, then there's only one way. तो उस केस में हमारे पास सिर्फ एक ही वे है, only one way you can multiply it. But if we have three matrices, so this is the matrix A, matrix B and matrix C. If you have to do this kind of multiplication, now in this case, there are basically two ways in which you can multiply them. How you can do it? So either you can do A cross B and you can do A cross B cross C. So we have two ways in which we can multiply these matrices. But if we have four matrix, agar aapke paas char matrix hai, then in how many ways you can do it? So if we have A cross B cross C cross D, and let us assume all of these matrices are compatible, okay? Then in how many ways you can do this multiplication? Aap kitne tarike se multiplication kar sakte hain? The first way will be, you can do A cross B, let me do it this way, A cross B cross C, and result you can multiply with D, and further this can be multiplied in two different ways. So that is A cross B cross C, and result you are multiplying with D. Or you can do it in this way, A cross B cross C, and you can multiply the result with D. Okay, so this is, these are the two ways here. Okay, and further you can also do it in this manner, that you are multiplying with A with B, and then you are multiplying C with D, and you are multiplying the result. And then this is a third manner here, that is, if we have, I can do it in this manner, that we have A cross B cross C cross D, and further it can be multiplied in two manner, which is A cross B cross C cross D, as well as A cross B cross C, and result I'm multiplying with D. Okay, right? So that means if we have basically four matrices, in how many ways you can multiply? You can multiply them in five ways. Aap inko five ways mein multiply kar sakte hain. So this is the first way. Ye aapka pehla tarika hai. The first way, this is representing your second way. This is first way, this is representing your second way, and this is representing your third way. ये आपका थर्ड रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है, दिस इज थर्ड वे, एंड दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग योर फोर्थ वे, एंड दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग योर फिफ्थ वे. ओके, सो देयर आर बेसिकली टोटल फाइव वेज इन विच यू कैन मल्टीप्लाई फोर मैट्रिसेस. सो लेट मी एक्सप्लेन इन दिस मैनर. सो दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग द नंबर ऑफ मैट्रिक्स, एंड दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग द नंबर ऑफ वेज. ओके, so if the number of matrices are 2, that is A cross B, in that case there is only one way to multiply them. If the number of matrices are 3, that is A cross B cross C, in that case there are two ways in which you can multiply them. If the number of matrices are 4, which is A cross B cross C cross D, in that case there are total 5 ways in which you can multiply them. In the same way, if there are 5 matrices, so that is A cross B cross C cross D, so if there are total of 5 matrices, in this case there are 14 ways to multiply them. यू कैन एक्सटेंड इट एनी नंबर ऑफ टाइम. सो इफ आई से दैट नंबर ऑफ मैट्रिसेस आर एन, अगर आपके पास टोटल एन मैट्रिसेस है, इन दिस केस इन हाउ मेनी वेज यू कैन मल्टीप्लाई दीज एन मैट्रिसेस, सो यू कैन मल्टीप्लाई देम इन 2n फैक्टोरियल डिवाइड बाय n प्लस 1 फैक्टोरियल इनटू n फैक्टोरियल वेज. इन दीज मेनी वेज यू कैन मल्टीप्लाई दीज मैट्रिसेस. सो यू कैन वेरीफाई द रिजल्ट ऑल्सो, यू कैन पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ n एज 4 एंड देन यू कैन चेक इफ योर आंसर इज मैचिंग और नॉट. सो बेसिकली दिस इज अ फॉर्मूला दैट यू शुड रिमेंबर एंड दिस फॉर्मूला कैन बी आस्क्ड डायरेक्टली इन द क्वेश्चन. ये जो फॉर्मूला है ये आई मीन डायरेक्टली इन एग्जाम में पूछा जा सकता है. दिस कैन बी आस्क्ड डायरेक्टली इन द एग्जाम. सो यू शुड नो दिस फॉर्मूला दैट इन हाउ मेनी वेज यू कैन मल्टीप्लाई द मैट्रिसेस. इज इट क्लियर सो फार? इतना सभी के साथ क्लियर है? ओके, सो लेट मी रिपीट अगेन वट एवर वी हैव डन सो फार. वी हैव सीन वट इज द मैट्रिक्स मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड हाउ कैन वी मल्टीप्लाई द मैट्रिक्स. सेकेंडली वी हैव सीन हाउ कैन वी डू वट आर द डिफरेंट वेज ऑफ मल्टीप्लाइंग थ्री मैट्रिसेस. And third, we have seen that matrix multiplication is not commutative. That means A multiplied by B is not equal to B multiplied by A. And the fourth one is we have seen in how many ways we can multiply matrices. If we have 4 matrices, there are 5 ways. If we have 5 matrices, there are 14 ways. If we have n matrices, there are 2n factorial divided by n plus 1 factorial into n factorial ways. So it should be clear with all of you. Okay. Now, if it is clear, let me give you one more example here. I'll take one more example where I will try and multiply 4 matrices, and I'm going to show you in what will be the number of multiplications are required in that case. So let us assume that we have 4 matrices. We have a matrix A with the dimensions of 1 cross 2. We have a matrix B with the dimensions of 2 cross 1. We have a matrix C with the dimensions of 1 cross 5. And we have a matrix D with the dimensions of 5 cross 1. So I want to do multiplication between these 4 matrices. Okay, so that is A, B, C, D. So if you want to do the multiplications, so in how many ways you can do this multiplication? Kitne tarike se aap isko kar sakte hain? So I'm going to write in this manner. This is A, B, C, D. You want to multiply them. So in how many ways you can do this multiplication? So first of all, you can multiply this A with B, C, D. And then you can multiply this AB with CD, and then you can multiply this ABC with D. In this manner, again, there are two types are required. I mean, two ways you can do it. So A multiplied by BCD, and then A multiplied by BC and D. Okay. And in this manner also, there are two ways are possible. That is A multiplied by BC multiplied by D, or AB multiplied by C multiplied by D. So these are basically 5 ways in which you can do this multiplication. In 5 tarike se aap inki multiplication kar sakte hain. Now my question is, what is the number of multiplications required in this case? Yahan par kitni multiplications ki requirement hogi? Okay, so in the first one, if you look at the first one, let me try to decrease the size of the pen also, because I believe smaller pen will be required for this. So if you do the first one here, that is for C and D. For this C and D, agar aap C or D ke bare mein check karenge, for C and D, the number of multiplications required will be 1 into 5 into 1. Okay? And the dimensions, jo iska result aayega, resultant will be having a dimensions of 1 cross 1. Right, because the dimension of C is 1 cross 5, as you can see here, dimension of C is 1 cross 5, dimension of D is 5 cross 1. So the number of multiplications that will be required is 1 cross 5 cross 1, which is equal to 5 multiplication. And the resultant will be having a dimension of 1 cross 1. And then you are going to multiply this result by B. Iska jo bhi result aayega, aapko B ke saath multiply karna hai. So B is having a dimension of 2 cross 1. So that is B is having a dimension of 2 cross 1. And this E is having a dimensions of 1 cross 1. So the number of multiplications that are required will be 2 cross 1 cross 1, that is equal to 2. Okay, and the resultant will be your matrix. Let us assume the resultant matrix here is F, and then you are going to multiply this resultant matrix with A. So this matrix A is having a dimension of 1 cross 2, and the resultant matrix will be having a dimension of 2 cross 1. Therefore, 1 cross 2 cross 1, that is equal to 2 multiplications will be required. So in total, if I calculate, what is the total number of multiplications? Total number of multiplications, that will be 5 plus 2 plus 2 is equal to 9. So there are total 9 multiplications are required in the first method. पहले method में हमें 9 multiplications की requirement होगी. Okay. Now let us see the second method here. So if I multiply with B with C, so B is having a dimension 2 cross 1 and C is having the dimension 1 cross 5. So the resultant matrix, maybe it is a E matrix, and this E matrix will be having a dimension of 2 cross 5. Okay. And if you do B multiplied by C, here how many multiplications are required? That is 2 cross 1 cross 5, which is equal to total 10 multiplications. Okay, तो उस केस में हमें 10 multiplications की requirement होगी. Now, I'm going to multiply E with D. So, D is having a dimension of 5 cross 1 and E is having a dimension of 2 cross 5. So, the resultant matrix will be F and it will be having a dimension of 2 cross 1. And what is the number of multiplications required? कितनी multiplications requirement थी यहाँ पर? That is 2 cross 5 cross 1, which is equal to total 10. Okay, and then you are going to multiply the result with A. आप इसका जो result है उसको A के साथ multiply करेंगे. So that will be A multiplied with F, that is 2 cross 1, and A is having a dimension of 1 cross 2. Hence the resultant matrix will be G, and this resultant matrix will be having a dimensions of 1 cross 1. And the number of multiplications required is 1 cross 2 cross 1. So total number of multiplications is 10 plus 10 plus 2, that is equal to 22 multiplications. तो यहाँ पर आपके पास 22 multiplications की requirement होगी. Okay, so in this case 22 multiplications are required. If you check out the third case here, so let us see this third case. So here if I do A multiplied by B, the number of multiplications are 1 cross 2 cross 1, plus if I do C multiplied by D, the number of multiplications are 1 cross 5 cross 1, that is equal to 2 plus 5 equal to 7. So in this manner, there are only 7 multiplications are required. यहाँ पर सिर्फ 7 multiplications से हमारा काम हो जाएगा. Only 7 multiplications are required. But if you look at this fourth way, so first of all, I have to do B multiplied by C. So B multiplied by C, total number of multiplications required is 10 multiplications. So I'm doing it in a shortcut manner because that will save a lot of time. And then the resultant matrix of B multiplied by C will be having a dimension of 2 cross 5. So if I do multiplication with A, so it is 1 cross 2 cross 5, that is equal to 10 multiplications are required. And the resultant matrix here will be having a dimensions of 1 cross 5. So I can again multiply with D, and then in that case 1 cross 5 cross 1 multiplications are required, which is equal to total 5. So if I calculate the total number of multiplications that is required here is going to be 10 plus 5, that is equal to 25 multiplications. So यहाँ पर 25 multiplications की requirement होगी. Okay. If you look at this last case, so in this last case, if I do A multiplied by B, so in A multiplied by B, number of multiplications required is going to be 2, and the resultant matrix will be having a dimensions of 1 cross 1. And if I multiply with C, the resultant, then it will be 1 cross 5 cross 1. So that is equal to 5 multiplications. And if I multiply the result with D, so that is going to be total 1 cross 5 cross 1, that is 5 multiplications. So if I calculate the total number of multiplications that is required is 2 plus 5 plus 5, which is equal to 12 multiplications that are required. So that means the most efficient way of multiplying these matrices is this one. ये सबसे efficient way है. This is the most efficient way. Because if we will multiply these matrices in this manner, then we will save lot of time in terms of computation. तो हमारा जो computer system है, we can save lot of time in computations of your computer system. This is the reason behind the concept. Okay. Now the problem here is, if we have to do such small computations, then your computer system is more than enough. It is more than capable to perform these multiplications. But if we have some very huge data, maybe you are having some terabytes of data, you are having thousands and thousands of matrices to multiply. So in that case, it will become very complicated to perform all of those calculations, because in all of those calculations, you are going to waste a lot of computation power, and because the number of multiplications that you have to do is going to be too much. So obviously in that case, you are going to take a lot of time complexity will increase unnecessarily. It will take a lot of time, right? okay, let me repeat again what I'm trying to say. So all I'm trying to say is कि यहाँ पर हमने सिर्फ चार मैट्रिसेस को मल्टीप्लाई किया, सो इन ओनली इन फोर मैट्रिसेस, एंड द डायमेंशंस ऑफ ऑल ऑफ दिस फोर मैट्रिसेस वर आल्सो वेरी स्मॉल. सो यू कैन सी 1x2 इज अ वेरी स्मॉल डायमेंशन, 2x1 इज अ वेरी स्मॉल डायमेंशन, 1x5 इज अ वेरी स्मॉल डायमेंशन, 5x1 इज अ वेरी स्मॉल डायमेंशन. सो बिकॉज डायमेंशन ऑफ ऑल ऑफ दिस मैट्रिसेस आर ऑल्सो वेरी स्मॉल एंड द नंबर ऑफ मैट्रिसेस आर ऑल्सो वेरी स्मॉल, सो फॉर योर कंप्यूटर सिस्टम एनी वे एनी मेथड यू इवेल्युएट यू विल नॉट फील द डिफरेंस. The only way when you will feel the difference is when you will be having huge number of matrices to multiply. So maybe it is a scientific data. So that is a data from regarding images, right? Jo aapki images hoti hain, if we have some images, so images can also be represented with a matrix. So maybe I have to represent a circle, then I can represent in this manner. Okay, so I can represent circle here. So there are many ways in which you can do it. Okay, so what we want to do is, हम लोग करना क्या चाहते हैं, what we want to do is, we want to find a way to multiply the matrices in such a manner that the number of multiplications can be reduced. अगर आपके पास बहुत ज़्यादा matrices है, maybe you want to multiply thousands of matrices. If you want to multiply thousands of matrices, then I want to minimize the number of effort to multiply those thousands of matrices. For that, I need a program to know कि when what is the number, in what manner you should multiply the matrix. Okay, so let me answer your question first of all. Okay, so let me answer in this manner. So let us assume that you have these matrices. This is A1, this is A2, this is A3, this is A4, up to so on. This is representing AN, and all of them are representing a matrix. A1 एक matrix को represent करता है, A2 is representing a matrix, A3 is representing a matrix, A4 is representing a matrix. All of them are representing a matrix, and what you want to do, you want to multiply these matrices. You want to multiply these matrices. So now, because these number of matrices are very huge, there are a lot of matrices here. Number of matrices are very huge. So because the number of matrices are very huge, therefore a lot of multiplications is required. And let us assume that they are having some dimensions. So the dimensions of A1 is P0 cross P1. The dimensions of A2 is P1 cross P2. The dimensions of A3 is P2 cross P3. The dimensions of A4 is P3 cross P4. In the same manner, the dimensions of AN is PN minus 1 cross PN. This is the dimension. ठीक है, तो हमें इन मैट्रिसेस को मल्टीप्लाई करना है एंड द डायमेंशंस ऑफ दिस मैट्रिसेस आर गिवन. नाउ आई वांट टू राइट एन एल्गोरिथम व्हिच शुड टेल मी इन व्हाट मैनर शुड आई मल्टीप्लाई दीज मैट्रिसेस सो दैट द नंबर ऑफ मल्टीप्लिकेशंस कैन बी मिनिमाइज्ड. ओके, सो दिस इज व्हाट आई हैव टू डू. द प्रॉब्लम इज क्लियर विद ऑल ऑफ यू, आप सभी के साथ प्रॉब्लम क्लियर है, बट वी आर ट्राइंग टू सॉल्व. हम लोग क्या करना चाहते हैं, आई वॉन्ट टू राइट अ सूडो कोड, आई वॉन्ट टू राइट एन एल्गोरिथम विच कैन टेल मी वट विल बी द मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ मल्टीप्लिकेशंस रिक्वायर्ड to multiply these n matrices, where n can be a very large number. Now I can give you a generalized method what I want to do, because when you want to do the multiplication, basically what you are trying to do is you are trying to parenthesize them ki hame kis kis ko group karna hai, kis kis ko group nahi karna, what are the matrices we have to group and what are the matrices we do not have to group. This is what I want to do. Okay, so I can also say it in this manner, I can also say the same thing in this manner. So I can also generalize the same problem in this manner. मैं इस problem को कुछ इस तरीके से भी generalize कर सकता हूँ. Let me do it in this way. So I can also generalize the same problem in this manner. So that is, I can say these matrices as AI cross AI plus 1 cross AI plus 2 cross AI plus 3 up to so on A J, okay, where this J is representing the value n. ये जो J है ये हमारे n को represent कर रहा है, and this I is representing your value 1. So I mean this AI is representing A1, this AI plus 1 is representing A2, and this AI plus 1 is representing A3. I mean this AI plus 2 is representing A3 and so on, and this AJ is representing AN. ये जो AJ है वो AN को represent कर रहा है. Okay, fine. Now What I want is, I want to find a method in which I can parenthesize them. So I can write in this manner that I want to make AI, AI plus one, up to so on, AK in one group, and I want to bring AK plus one to AK plus two, up to so on, AJ in other group, in such a way that this value of K can loop. So the value of K should be between I to J. इसकी जो वैल्यू है वो I to J के बीच में होनी चाहिए. And this one, the resultant of this one will be having a dimensions of P I minus 1 to K, and this, the resultant matrix of this one will be having a dimensions of P K to P J. ठीक है, तो यानी कि इसका जो मल्टीप्लीकेशन होगा, सो द मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ द फर्स्ट सेट विल बी हैविंग द रिजल्टेंट मैट्रिक्स ऑफ द फर्स्ट सेट विल बी हैविंग अ डायमेंशंस ऑफ पी आई माइनस वन इन टू पी के, एंड द रिजल्टेंट सेट ऑफ द सेकेंड रिजल्टेंट मैट्रिक्स ऑफ द सेकेंड सेट विल बी हैविंग अ डायमेंशंस ऑफ पी के इन टू पी जे. तो ये इनकी रिजल्टेंट डायमेंशंस हैं, द डायमेंशंस ऑफ रिजल्टेंट मैट्रिक्स, डायमेंशंस of resultant matrix. Okay, this is presenting the dimensions of resultant matrix. Now in these dimensions of resultant matrix, you can see that these resultant matrices are also compatible. Ye compatible hai. These resultant matrices are also compatible. Okay, so I hope this much is clear. Now if this much is clear, so obviously you should know, sir, how can we do it? I mean, how can we write a recursive function for this? इसके लिए हम recursive function कैसे लिख सकते हैं? So writing the recursive function is fairly very easy, just by looking at this relation. So you can write a recursive function for this. Recursive function that can perform this multiplication. So this recursive function, obviously you should understand कि हमने कैसे किया है, but again in UGC NET exam they are not going to ask for the program. So programs is only important for the gate examination most of the time. In UGC NET they are going to ask very simple problems here. Okay, so here I am going to represent in this manner. I am going to say M of I comma J, that means I want to multiply the matrices from AI to AJ. मुझे AI से लेकर AJ matrix तक multiply करना है. So this is representing the number of multiplications required for multiplying from AI to AJ. Okay, then this is equal to 0 if I is equal to J. यानी कि अगर आपके पास सिर्फ एक matrix है, if you have only one matrix, then there is no multiplication is required. But if you have more than one matrix, then you have to parenthesize. If you have more than one matrix, then what you can do, you can find out what is the number of multiplications required between I to K. हमें इस I से लेकर K तक multiply करने के लिए कितनी multiplications की requirement होगी. What is the number of multiplications required from multiplying I to K, plus the number of multiplications required for multiplying K to J, and then this resultant, obviously to multiply this resultant we will be requiring P I minus 1 multiplied by P K into P J multiplications. तो ये जो इनका रिजल्टेंट है, सो दिस इज द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ मैट्रिक्स, एंड दिस विल बी रिक्वायरिंग पी आई माइनस वन इंटू पी के इंटू पी जे मल्टीप्लीकेशन. एंड नाउ वी हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट वी कैन पैरेंथेसाइज दिस मैट्रिसेस इन लॉट ऑफ वेज. ऑब्वियसली वी कैन पैरेंथेसाइज दिस मैट्रिसेस इन मेनी वेज. सो आई कैन डू इज, आई कैन से दैट आई कैन चेंज द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस के. सो दिस इज मिनिमम फ्रॉम आई लेस देन इक्वल टू के लेस देन इक्वल लेस देन जे. दिस इज वॉट वी वॉन्ट टू फाइंड अदरवाइज. Okay, so I hope that you did not, I think so that you did not understood this. Let me try and explain this again. Okay, so I think you could not understand this. Let me explain this again clearly. Okay, so let us assume I want to do the multiplications from 1 to 3, right? So that means I want to multiply the matrix A1 cross A2 cross A3. So I want to do the multiplications of these three matrices. So first of all, this one is representing the value of I, and these three is representing the value of J. Therefore, here 1 is not equal to 3. So this condition is फॉल्स, ये जो कंडीशन आपकी, ये आपकी फॉल्स रहेगी. सो बिकॉज दिस कंडीशन इज फॉल्स, आई एम गोइंग टू गो विद द सेकेंड कंडीशन. सो सेकेंड कंडीशन सेज दैट फाइंड द मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन इफ आई मल्टीप्लाई दिस वैल्यू ऑफ के कैन बी यू नो चेंज्ड. सो फाइंड द मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन इफ आई डू एम ऑफ 1, 1. अगर हम 1, 1 को मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे, ओके, एंड इफ आई डू एम ऑफ 2, 3 एंड द नंबर ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन रिक्वायर्ड फॉर दीज वैल्यूज, राइट. सो आई मीन लेट मी एक्सप्लेन व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से हियर इज, व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से हियर इज दैट आई एम गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई ए सॉरी सो व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से हियर इज इन दिस मैनर I'm trying to say here is that I'm going to multiply A1 with A2 and A3. This is what I'm trying to say. Okay? And if I'm doing it, then the dimensions of the first matrix is basically P0 multiplied by PK that is equal to 1 multiplied by PJ that is equal to 3. P3. Multiplied by P3, comma. And if I change this value of K to 2, so I can also do it in this manner. So I can do A1 cross A2 and resultant I'm trying to multiply with A3. Iska jo resultant hai usko main A3 ke saath multiply karne ki koshish karo. So in this case, in this second method, it will be M of 1, 2 plus M of 3, 3 plus P0 multiplied by PK which is equal to 2 multiplied by PJ which is equal to 3. This is what I'm trying to say. Okay. Further, you can evaluate this value, right? So this value is equal to 0. Why? Because this is given. So this value is equal to 0. And then you can evaluate what is the number of multiplications required if you multiply with A2 with A3. अगर हम A2 और A3 को मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे तो कितनी मल्टीप्लीकेशन रिक्वायरमेंट होगी, प्लस व्हाट इज द नंबर ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन रिक्वायर्ड हियर. सो मैं इसको इसके साथ ऐड करूंगा, देन आई कैन गेट द टोटल वैल्यू. इन द सेम मैनर हियर ऑल्सो आई कैन डू मल्टीप्लीकेशन इज A1 and 2 एंड देन दिस वैल्यू विल बी इक्वल टू 0 एंड देन आई एम गोइंग टू ऐड इट विद दिस वैल्यू. ओके, सो आई कैन फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज द नंबर ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन रिक्वायर्ड हियर, आई कैन फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज द नंबर ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन रिक्वायर्ड इन दिस केस ऑल्सो. ओके, do one thing, please write this down in your notebooks from here to here. Please write this down in your notebook and then we'll move forward. So majorly this recursive relation, pehle aap is recursive relation ko apni notebook mein likh lijiye please, and please write down in the chat window once you are done with this recursive relation, because we are going to need this recursive relation in our examples. So now we know that there exists an optimal substructure here. So we have already covered what is optimal substructure. Let me again remind you. Optimal substructure means it is those functions which are repeating themselves. Those function calls or which are repeating themselves. If they are repeating themselves, then we can say that optimal substructure exists. So first of all, I should know that if I'm trying to multiply a few matrices, does there exist an optimal substructure or not? Okay, let me explain in this manner. So let us assume that I want to multiply 4 matrices. I have a matrix A1, I have a matrix A2, I have a matrix A3, and I have a matrix A4. Okay, I'm not really worried about these calculations. मुझे ये calculations नहीं चाहिए. I do not need these calculations as of now. I just want to know that if I'm doing these recursive function calls, then will there be any recursive function calls that will be repeating itself, right? So in how many ways we can multiply this? I told you there are total of 5 ways in which you can multiply them. Okay, so in the first way I can say M of 1, 1 plus M of 2, 4. Okay, secondly I can say M of 1, 2 plus M of 3, 4, and thirdly it will be M of 1, 3 plus M of 3, 4, 4. Okay, further in this case also there are 2 ways, so which is M of 2, 2 plus M of 3, 4, and here also it is M of 2, 3 plus m of 4 comma 4, and further this can be multiplied into m of 3 comma 3 and m of 4 comma 4, and further here also m of 2 comma 2 and m of 3 comma 3. In this same manner here also m of 1 comma 1, and here we'll be having m of 2 comma 2. In this case also we'll be having m of 3 comma 3 plus m of 4 comma 4. Okay. In this case again this is going to be m of 1 comma 1 plus m of 2 comma 3, or we cannot do it in this manner also, which is m of 1 comma 2 plus m of 3 comma 3. Further this can be done in two ways, that is m of 2 comma 2 and m of 3 comma 3, and this can also be done in two ways, which is m of 1 comma 1 and m of 2 comma 2. Okay, so this is basically how I have found this table. मैंने इसको कैसे create किया? I have created this table because of this recursive substructure. I have seen this recursive substructure. I am just trying to know what are the number of these recursive calls. ये कितनी recursive calls होने वाली? How many number of recursive calls will be there? So I am not calculating this multiplication. I am just trying to find what is the number of recursive calls. And in these recursive calls, you can clearly see there are a lot of recursive calls which are repeating themselves. ऐसी बहुत सारी रिकर्सिव कॉल्स होंगी जो अपने आप को रिपीट कर रही हैं. सो फॉर एग्जांपल हियर वी हैव एम ऑफ 3 कॉमा 3 इज हियर एज वेल एज एम ऑफ 3 कॉमा 3 इज आल्सो हियर, एम ऑफ 3 कॉमा 3 इज आल्सो हियर, एम ऑफ 3 कॉमा 3 इज आल्सो हियर, एम ऑफ 3 कॉमा 3 इज आल्सो हियर. सो एम ऑफ 3 कॉमा 3 इज रिपीटिंग इटसेल्फ मेनी नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स. इन द सेम वे इफ आई चेक एम ऑफ 1 कॉमा 1, सो एम ऑफ 1 कॉमा 1 इज प्रेजेंट हियर एज वेल एज इट इज आल्सो प्रेजेंट हियर, as well as it is also present here, as well as it is also present here. So this is also repeating itself in function calls. And if I look at m of 2 comma 2, so 2 comma 2 is present here, as well as it is also present here, as well as it is also present here, it is also present here, and it is also present here. So basically all of these function calls are repeating themselves. So obviously there exists an optimal substructure because there are a lot of recursive calls which are repeating themselves. What we can do is to take the benefit of dynamic programming, we can store them in a array. हम इनको एक array के अंदर store कर सकते हैं. So again, there are two methods here. Either we can apply bottom up approach, or we can also apply top down approach. So here, top down approach is also possible. But again, I'm not showing you the top down approach because it is little complicated as compared to bottom up approach. So I just want to store these recursive calls in a bottom up fashion. That's it. क्लियर है सभी के साथ? इज इट क्लियर सो फार? ओके, सो इफ यू लुक एट पर्टिकुलर विद द हाइट ऑफ दिस गिवन स्ट्रक्चर, ये जो ट्री है, सो ऑब्वियसली इट इज काइंड ऑफ क्रिएटिंग अ बाइनरी ट्री, राइट? सो व्हाट इज द हाइट ऑफ दिस बाइनरी ट्री? द हाइट ऑफ दिस बाइनरी ट्री विल बी ऑर्डर ऑफ एन. दैट विल बी द हाइट ऑफ दिस बाइनरी ट्री एन. व्हाट इज द नंबर ऑफ रिकर्सिव कॉल्स? व्हाट इज द नंबर ऑफ रिकर्सिव कॉल्स हियर? हाउ मेनी रिकर्सिव कॉल्स विल बी देयर? सो द नंबर ऑफ रिकर्सिव कॉल्स विल बी इक्वल टू ऑर्डर ऑफ 2 raised to power n. So basically this algorithm, so this function that I've given you, this function here, it is an exponential time function. ये जो function है वो exponential time function है because the number of recursive calls will be in order of 2 raised to power n. Or and to create a multiplication that requires constant time, but again number of function calls that we will be having here is order of 2 raised to power n. Hence, because this cannot be solved in linear time, as well as there is optimal substructure exists, therefore we can apply the concepts of dynamic programming to solve this problem. Clear as a big sir? Is it clear so far? So basically if you see these values, we already know these values because I told you that whenever I is equal to j, in that case I can say the value is 0. Therefore here in these recursive calls its value will be 0, this value is 0, this value is 0, this value is 0, this value is 0, all these values are 0. So there are few values that we already know, but we have to calculate the other values. Okay? So how can I do it? I can create a table for this. Let me create the table. Okay, let me try to do it in this manner. Okay, so I've created a table here, right? And each entry here, this entry is representing 1, 1. Sorry, this entry is representing 1, 1. This entry is representing 2, 2. This entry is representing 3, 3. And this entry is representing 4, 4. That means this is representing M of 4, 4. Okay, here this entry is representing 1, 2. That is, it is representing M of 1, 2. Fine. So it is, and this entry is representing 2, 3. This is representing 3, 4. This is representing 1, 3. This is representing 2, 4. And this is representing 1, 4. Okay. So if you take any entry here, if I take this entry, so this entry is representing M of 3, 4. Okay. So M of 3, 4, I told you, if you look at this function, just look at your notebook, look at this function here, and please check it out in your notebook. Whenever I write M of 3, 4, then it is equal to M of 3, 3 plus M of 4, 4 plus P2 cross P3 cross P4. Okay, this will be having this value, right? So this is M of 3, 4. Right, so we already know a few values here. हमें कुछ values यहाँ पर already पता है. Okay, so we already know this value. This value is going to be 0. This value is also 0. This value is also 0. This value is also 0. Now we already know a few value. Now I can calculate the other values. Okay, so for example here, this is representing M of 1, 2. So because it is representing M of 1, 2, therefore it will be equal to M of 1, 1 plus M of 2, 2 plus P0 multiplied by P1 multiplied by P2. Okay, let us assume these are the three matrices A1, A2, A3 and A4. I'm taking some example here. I'm taking, let us say, the dimensions of a matrix A1 is 1 cross 2. The dimensions of A2 is 2 cross 1. The dimensions of A3 is 1 cross 4. And the dimensions of A4 is 4 cross 1. These are dimensions of these matrices. Okay. Now, in this manner, agar hum yahan par check karenge, in this manner, so if I do M of 1, 2, so what will be the value of M of 1, 2? M of 1, 2 means I want to multiply A1 cross A2. M of 1, 2 ka matlab hai ki hum A1 cross A2 ki value ko find out karna chahte hain. So this A1 cross A2 value will be equal to 0 plus 0 plus this value, which is P0, that is equal to 1 cross P1, which is equal to 2 cross 1. So this entire value will be equal to 2. Ye jo puri value hai, that will be equal to 2. So this entire value will be equal to 2. So I'm going to write 2 here. Clear? If it is not clear, let me repeat again. So you will try to understand this here. So ye jo hai aapke paas, this location. This location is representing M of 2, 3. What is M of 2, 3? It means I want to do A2 cross A3. And A2 ki dimensions kya hai? What is the dimensions of A2? The dimensions of A2 is 2 cross 1. And the dimensions of A3 is 1 cross 4. So this 2, 3 is representing, I want to multiply A2 cross A3 here. For this, I want to multiply A2 cross A3. Therefore, this will be equal to M of 2, 2 plus M of 3, 3 plus this is P1 cross P2 cross P3. So this value we already know, because this value here is 0. This value we already know, this is 0. And this value here, P1 here, is representing 2, 1, 4. So that is equal to 8. So yahan par jo value aayegi, that will be equal to 8. Okay. In the same manner, I can evaluate this value. So A3 cross A4. So this value here, this will be 0. This will be 0. And what will be this value? This value is going to be 1 cross 4 cross 1, that is equal to 4. So yahan par jo value aayegi, that will be equal to 4. Okay. I hope it is clear so far. Itna sab ek sath clear hoga. Now if I take this location here, so this location means I want to do a multiplication, which is M of 2, 4. So that is, I want to do A2 cross A3. So again this can be done in this manner. So this is equal to minimum of, just see the recursive equation in your notebook that you have written, jo recursive equation apni notebook ke andar likhi hai, please have a look at that. So it is representing minimum of, first of all that is m of 2, 2 plus m of 3, 4 plus p1 cross p2 cross p4, okay. And secondly it will be equal to comma, we have to take a minimum value, right? So that is m of 2, 3 plus m of 4, multiplied by p1 cross p3 cross p4, okay. So we already know a few values. So ye jo value hai, this value is 0. And what is this value? It's for checking this value, all you have to do is go to the table. I want to check this value, so I have to go to this location which is m of 3, 4. So mujhe yahan par jana hai and I can take this value. And this value represented is 4. And I can do this calculation easily. So p1 cross p2 cross p4. Here it is having a dimensions. A2 is having a dimensions of, so this is A4, right? So A2 is having a dimensions of 2 cross 1, A3 is having a dimensions of 1 cross 4, A4 is having a dimensions of 1 cross 4 cross 1, right? So if I do P1 is 2 cross P2. So P2 is having dimensions 1 cross and P4 is having a dimensions of 1. So that means this entire multiplication is 6. In the same way, you can also evaluate the value of this one. Yahan par jo m of 2, 3 hai, what will be the value of m of 2, 3? This value is equal to 8. So I'm going to write 8 here. What is the value of m of 4, 4? This value is equal to 0. And then I evaluate this value. And this value is representing u p1 cross p3 cross p4. So p1 is representing a value that is equal to 2 cross p3 is representing a value which is equal to 1. So p3 is having a value 4 cross p4 is having a value 1. So that is equal to 8. So total value here is 16. So therefore minimum answer here, minimum value will be total equal to 6. So yahan par jo value aayegi that will be equal to 6. So in this manner you can fill this entire table. Yes, p value is little bit confusing. All you have to do is to find out the value of p, all you have to do is you have to start calculating it. After the class, just do one thing, take your notebooks and start calculating these values. Once you will calculate these values, this will become very easy, right? So I can also write it here. So this is representing P0, this is P1, this is P1, this is P2, this is P2, this is P3, this is P3, and this is P4. Okay, so you can write it somewhere in your notebook, and whenever I want to use these values, I can just substitute those values over there. Let me take this value here. Okay, so this value is little lengthy, but I'll take it. So this is representing m of 1, 3. So that means I want to do a multiplication between a1 cross a2 cross a3. So a1 is having a dimensions of 1, 2, a2 is having a dimensions of 2 cross 1, and a3 is having a dimensions of 1 cross 4. Therefore this value will be equal to minimum of m of 1, 1 plus m of 2, 3 plus this is going to be p, just go back here again, so you will see it is pi minus 1, right? So this will be equal to p0 cross p1 cross p3, okay. And then the second value here will be m of 1, 2 plus m of 3, 3 plus p0 cross p2 cross p3. So in ki values hume already pata hai, we already know these values. So this 1, 1 is having a value 0, and this 2, 3, so go to this table 2, 3, this 2, 3 is having a value 8, and this p0 is having a value 1 cross p1 is having a value of 2 cross p3 is having a value of 4. So this entire value is 16. Okay, so on one side I'm getting a value 16. In the same way here I go to 1, 2, so 1, 2 is having a value 2, 3, 3 is having a value 0, and this p0 is representing 1 cross p2 is representing 1 cross p3 is representing 4. So that is equal to total of 6. So that means this value is also 6. So aapke paas ye wali value bhi 6 aa jayegi. In the same way यू हैव टू डू दिस मल्टीप्लीकेशन. अब आपको इस मल्टीप्लीकेशन की रिक्वायरमेंट है, सो टू डू दिस मल्टीप्लीकेशन वी ऑलरेडी हैव अ फ्यू वैल्यूज, यू जस्ट हैव टू इंसर्ट दोज वैल्यूज. सो बेसिकली दिस इज अ अरे, ये जो है ये एक अरे है. सो इफ वी हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई एन, यू नो, इफ यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई एन मैट्रिसेस, सो दिस अरे विल बी हैविंग अ डायमेंशंस ऑफ ऑर्डर ऑफ एन स्क्वायर. सो दैट इज अ डायमेंशंस ऑफ दिस अरे, डायमेंशन ऑफ अरे. इस अरे की जो डायमेंशन है दैट विल बी इक्वल टू ऑर्डर ऑफ एन स्क्वायर, बिकॉज इफ देर आर फोर मैट्रिसेस देयरफॉर द डायमेंशंस विल बी ऑर्डर ऑफ 16. ओके, सो दिस इज हाउ यू शुड नो दिस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस थिंग शुड बी क्लियर. अब आपके साथ ये चीज़ें क्लियर है, देन यू कैन सी प्रोग्राम टू इम्प्लीमेंट दिस. अब आप इसको प्रोग्राम देख सकते हैं, हाउ कैन यू इम्प्लीमेंट दिस यूजिंग द प्रोग्राम. नाउ सेकेंडली, दिस प्रोग्राम इज नॉट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यूजीसी नेट एग्जाम, बिकॉज इन यूजीसी नेट दे विल नॉट आस्क यू टू राइट द प्रोग्राम. इट इज ओनली इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अदर एग्जामिनेशंस लाइक गेट एंड यू नो इसरो एग्जामिनेशंस और अदर साइंटिस्ट एंट्री लेवल एग्जामिनेशन. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू स्किप दिस प्रोग्राम यू कैन ईजिली स्किप इट. सो बट अगेन लेट मी एक्सप्लेन यू, आपको बहुत ईजिली समझ में आ जाएगा. लेट मी एक्सप्लेन यू दिस प्रोग्राम. सो दिस इज द प्रोग्राम विच इज मैट्रिक्स चेन, राइट. हियर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई हैव टू इमेजिन, आई हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई वट इज द नंबर ऑफ मैट्रिसेस. सो दैट इज एन इज इक्वल टू पी डॉट लेंथ माइनस वन. सो इट इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग वट इज द नंबर ऑफ मैट्रिसेस दैट वी हैव. ओके, सो आई हैव टू क्रिएट टू टेबल्स हियर एंड देन फॉर I इज इक्वल टू वन टू n, आई हैव टू मेक m ऑफ I कॉमा I इज इक्वल टू जीरो. यानी कि हमें करना ये है कि ये जितनी भी लोकेशंस हैं, ऑल ऑफ दीज हॉरिजॉन्टल लोकेशंस, आई हैव टू फिल दीज वैल्यूज एज जीरो. आफ्टर फिलिंग दीज वैल्यूज एज जीरो, वट आई कैन डू इज आई कैन ट्राई टू द चेन मल्टी चेन लेंथ. सो आई कैन से फॉर l इज इक्वल टू 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 n, अगेन आई वन मोर लूप फॉर I इज इक्वल टू वन टू एन माइनस एल प्लस वन, J इज इक्वल टू I प्लस एल माइनस वन, एम ऑफ I कॉमा J इज इक्वल टू इन्फिनिटी, एंड देन अगेन फॉर K इज इक्वल टू I टू J माइनस वन, Q इज इक्वल टू एम ऑफ I कॉमा K प्लस एम ऑफ K प्लस वन टू J प्लस P1, PI minus 1, PK into PJ. If this Q is less than the already known value, then I'm going to do M of I comma J is equal to Q, and I can say S is equal to I comma J is equal to K. Okay, and then in the last I can say return M and S. So this is 5, this is statement number 6, this is statement number 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and I guess so 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and this is statement number 14. Okay, let me explain the program, what I'm trying to say. Okay, so look at it very carefully, look at it very, very carefully here. Yeah. So look at it very, very carefully here. So what I'm trying to say here is, देखो इफ वॉन्ट टू डू मल्टीप्लीकेशन बिटवीन टू मैट्रिक्स, जैसे यू हैव टू डू ए वन क्रॉस ए टू क्रॉस अप टू सो ऑन ए एन, अगर आपको एन मैट्रिसेस के बीच में मल्टीप्लीकेशन करना है, देन वट यू हैव टू डू इज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू क्रिएट टू टेबल्स. सो दिस इज योर फर्स्ट टेबल एंड दिस टेबल आई एम गोइंग टू कॉल एज एम. सो इन दिस फर्स्ट टेबल यू आर गोइंग टू हैव एम रोज, एन रोज एज वेल एज एन कॉलम, राइट. सो हियर जीरो वन यू कैन से, और फॉर सिंपलिसिटी आई विल से इट इज टोटल ऑफ 1, 2, 3, up to so on n, and again 1, 2, 3, up to so on n. This is your first table, okay? Now, in this first table, first of all, you have to take all the diagonal values. Why I have to take diagonal values? Because this value is representing 1, 1. This location is representing 2, 2. This location here, it is representing 3, 3. In the same way, this location here is representing n, n. So, jitni bhi diagonals hai, because I have to make all the diagonal values as 0. So, I have to make all the diagonal values as zero kar diya. I have to make all these diagonal values as zero. Why? Because if you see these locations here, ye jo locations hai yahan par, these locations are just representing the diagonal values only. Ye yahan par diagonal values ko hi represent kar rahi hai. That is 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 and 4, 4. After this, I have to fill only one part. Either I want to fill the upper part or I want to fill the lower part, because that will be exactly the same. Because you can clearly see this location here, it will be representing 1, 2. It will be representing m of 1, 2. And this location here, it will be representing m of 2, 3. So in this manner, I have to fill the upper part or I have to fill the lower part. That's it. Okay. In the same way, I have to take one more matrix here. Mujhe yahan par ek aur matrix lena hai. I have to take one more matrix. And the dimensions of this one more matrix is 1, 2, up to so on, n minus 1. Iski jo dimensions hai, wo hongi 1 se lekar n minus 1 tak. 1, 2, up to so on, n minus 1. And here it is 2, 3, up to so on, n. Right? So, ab is matrix ke andar what we have to store? I have to store where I have done the partition. Jaise ki, if I have the matrix A1 cross A2 cross A3 cross A4. अब मैंने यहाँ पर पार्टीशन कहाँ पर किया? Have I done the partition here? Or have I done the partition here? What are the locations I have done the partition? So this second matrix will be storing the location of the partition. The first matrix will be storing the number of multiplications, and second matrix will be storing the locations of the partition. Okay? So what I'm trying to do here is, in this case, I have to first of all evaluate. I'm trying to fill every location by infinity. हर एक लोकेशन पे मैंने इन्फिनिटी स्टोर किया. आई हैव टू स्टोर एवरी लोकेशन इन्फिनिटी हियर. आई हैव टू स्टोर इन्फिनिटी इन एवरी लोकेशन. आफ्टर स्टोरिंग इन्फिनिटी इज एवरी लोकेशन, आई एम ट्राइंग टू कैलकुलेट दिस वैल्यू. आई एम ट्राइंग टू सी, अगर मैं कहीं पर पार्टीशन करता हूँ, लेट अस सपोज इफ आई हैव A1, A2, अप टू सो ऑन AN, इफ आई डू अ पार्टीशन हियर, देन विल आई गेट अ वैल्यू विच इज मिनी लेस देन द ऑलरेडी नोन वैल्यूज? क्या वो जो वैल्यू है, जो हमें ऑलरेडी नोन वैल्यू है, क्या वो वैल्यू से कम है? बिकॉज यू कैन क्लियरली सी दिस function here, this statement here is basically representing this recursive equation. Your statement hai, wo is recursive equation ko represent kar rahi hai. Because in this recursive equation, you have to iterate the value of k, and after iterating the value of k, you have to see what is the minimum value you are getting. So yahan par k ki value ko iterate karna hai, jaise here you are iterating the value of k, and you have to see what is the minimum value that you are getting. Okay, to aapko wo sabhi values ko lena hai, and then you can try to see ki what is the minimum number of multiplications that you are getting. So if you are getting a minimum, if you are getting a number of multiplications which is less than the already known values, jaise ki currently agar yahan par infinity hai, and we are getting that 16 multiplications are required, so 16 is less than infinity, so I'm going to update this table. To main is table ko update kar dunga, and I'm going to put this location of k, ki humne partition kahan par kiya, what is the location we have done the partition. I'm going to store the value of k in this table. Jo k ki value hai humne wo is table ke andar store kari. So it is very simple. What I'm trying to do here is that I'm trying to create two tables. In the first table, I will store the number of multiplications. In the second table, I will store what is the location of partition for which I'm getting the minimum number of multiplications. That's it. Now, this entire program will be having a time complexity of order of n cube. Iski jo time complexity hai, wo order of n cube rahegi. Why it is having a time complexity of order of n cube? First of all, we have to fill a table which is of size order of n square. Ye jo aapki table m hai, this table m is of size order of n square. Then, for every location, I have to iterate the value of k up to n time. Jo k ki value hai, agar hamare paas a1 se lekar an tak hai, then the value of k will iterate from 1 to n, right? So for every location, I have to iterate the value of k, I have to perform n calculations. Therefore, here the total time complexity will be order of n cube. That is a time complexity for matrix chain multiplications. Okay. So I hope that you understood. Let me revise the entire topic again. Whatever I have done, kya kya kiya, so then you will be able to figure it out. First of all, we have seen how can we perform the matrices, how can you do the matrix multiplication. Then we have seen that if we do the matrix multiplication, then what will be the dimensions of the resultant matrix. Then we have seen what is the number of multiplications are required. Then I have taken one example. Then in this example, I have told you that the number of multiplications required to multiply three matrices will be different if we partition them in a different manner. Okay, after this, I told you that matrix multiplication is not commutative. That means you cannot do A multiplied by B is equal to B multiplied by A. That is not equal to that. Then I told you what is the number of ways you can multiply a matrix. If you have 4 matrices, then there are 5 ways. If you have 5 matrices, then there are 14 ways. If there are n matrices, then there are 2 into n factorial divided by n plus 1 factorial into n factorial ways. So this is just representing the number of ways of multiplying the matrix. After this, I have taken one example where I told you that number of multiplications that is required for these matrices are different. Then I've given you a recursive function. I've given you a recursive equation, recursive method to calculate these values. उसके बाद ये जो recursive method हमने calculate किया था, I've taken one example. I told you how can we do this calculation using the recursive method. And then I've applied a bottom-up dynamic programming approach and I tried to create an array here. And in this array, I'm trying to store these values, right? So I'm trying to remember or memorize the values that we have already evaluated. Jo values humne already memorized ki hai, the already jo humne yaad ki hai, un sabhi values ko humne yaha par store karna hai. I'm just trying to store those values. After this, I have given you a program that is going to perform this operation. But this program is not required for UGCNET. You can just study till this point of time. Itna aapko samajh mein aata, that is more than enough. You only need the time complexity of the function and you know, you need how can you do this multiplication. I mean, yahan tak kafi hai, more than this is not required at all. This is it. So that was your first session for matrix chain multiplication. Fine, I hope that you understood this session. Okay, so all you have to do is, after this session, please take some time and revise whatever things I've covered, because if you will try to revise the things that I've covered, then only you will be able to understand what I'm trying to say. Okay, so just one more interesting thing that I want to give you, ki whenever you're trying to revise, in that case, try to teach it to someone else. Okay, try to teach it to someone else. Because sometimes teaching to someone else clears the topic for us. It makes the topic easier for us. So during revision, try to see if you can teach to someone else, then 99% of the topic will be clear to you. Otherwise, sometimes it happens that you're not able to, remember the topic for a long time. You have to revise many number of times. So it happens. So best way to do revision and best way to understand a concept is to teach to someone else, because if that someone else is going to ask you questions, then you will be able to learn more. Wo jo dusra person hai, agar aapse question puchega to aap zyada seekh payenge. So it is better ki agar aapko koi concept padhna hai, agar aapko koi concept difficult lagta hai, the best way is to teach that concept to someone else. Kisi aur ko badhayenge, then you will be able to learn it for a long time. Theek hai, matlab aapko kafi lambe time tak yaad rahega and it will be easier for you. Theek hai.